Wells is a strange little place and one that is entirely overlooked in a historical context. But Wells is the home of some of the most elaborate rock ever cut in the history of civilization, and this leads us in our search for more. Would it surprise you to learn that the British National Trust operating in Wells have just reported the biggest Iron Age structure of all time? Just wait till you hear this one, guys. The Gwynedd Archaeological Trust have reported that an ancient fort in threat of coastal erosion has revealed secrets kept from the public domain for over 2,500 years. Amongst the ancient finds that included Roman-era pottery from a much later habitation of the site, the lead archaeologist Dan Amore described the findings as fantastic quality that could have been home to an important figure during the Iron Age. The site is dating back between 750 and 1,000 years BC, leading the researchers to question the integrity of the settlers. The researcher goes on to explain that, while we're still investigating and recording the remains of the ancient roundhouse, but considering its size and build quality, it may have been home to an important figure in the community, like the chief or head of the village, or it could have been used as a space for communal activities. The excavations are a result of excavations and how they have affected coastal settlements in the past and in the future. National Trust archaeologist Catherine Law said, "We are delighted that Cherish and the Gwynedd Archaeological Trust have been able to complete the dig at Deniston Hill. The discovery of a substantial stone-built roundhouse is very exciting. The structure is well preserved and is likely to date to from the late Iron Age period. The excavation has provided us with the opportunity to learn more about this special place's past and to better understand how climate change is affecting coastal heritage sites." Wells continues to reveal new aspects of its rich history. A student taking part in his first ever archaeological dig, for example, recently discovered an incredible axe dating back to the New Stone Age at Talsarn in Wales. Joe Neal, a second-year archaeological student at the University of Wales Trinity St. David, found the amazing Neolithic artifact during a dig at Talsarn in Wales. Neal was taking part in undergraduate field work when he made the remarkable find. "It's a great find for us. I couldn't have hoped to find anything better," he said in a statement. "This is my first dig and the first time I have found anything, so this is great." Other ancient sites in Wales has been revealing their secrets. Experts, for example, have been unlocking new details of a Roman villa, while other details of a possible Roman villa in Wales has revealed its secrets to archaeologists. The villa in West Wales was first discovered by aerial photography in 2006, which was located 31 miles from the nearest Roman villa. The site has long fascinated archaeologists, with just over 30 known or possible Roman villas believed to be in Wales, most of which are in the south or east of the country, according to the researchers. The Aber Maelgruer villa discovery sheds new light on an area previously thought to be a militarized zone, with little interaction between Romans and the local population and little adoption of Roman customs. Excavations at the site began in 2010, and at the time they were supported by the Royal Commission of the Ancient and Historical Monuments of Wales. The digs reveal that the villas were established around the year 230, which was at least a century after a nearby Roman fort was abandoned. It was occupied until around the year 330, when it was abandoned following a catastrophic fire. A cooking pot dropped on the kitchen floor was never picked up, showing the urgency of the excavation. The final excavation report in the Journal of Archaeologia Cambrensis details the artifacts discovered at the site was a Roman cut glass vessel, similar to a small bowl, is described as the star find of the excavation. Archaeologists were surprised to find fragments of such an ornate bowl. It was an extraordinary item of luxury for this modest villa, probably used for mixing wine and water at grand dinner parties and celebrations. The artifacts are the latest in a slew of fascinating finds from Roman Britain. Archaeologists, for example, recently discovered a 2,000-year-old Roman cemetery in Lincolnshire, England. In a separate project, a mysterious Roman bronze hand was discovered near Hadrian's Wall in the north of England. Earlier this year, archaeologists also unearthed ancient boxing gloves at the site at Vindolanda, just south of Hadrian's Wall, a protective guard designed to fit snugly over the knuckles. The gloves were packed with natural material, which acted as shock absorbers. They date from around the year 120 and were certainly made to last a person's career in the arts, as they still fit comfortably on a modern hand. One of them even retains the impressions of the knuckles of its ancient wearer. Many ancient finds now being uncovered in England and indeed in Wales regarding the ancient occupation of the island, and we just wanted to ask you guys what you thought about this strategic location, its refusal to fall under order even in Roman times, and what this means to us today. By the end of the first century, Rome had most of southern Britain under its control. However, it was a different story in Scotland. This was a much wilder place with different lifestyles from the rest of Europe. A militia race of survivors, which would only follow a sworn leader and was still controlled by fierce warrior tribes known as the Highlanders, who refused to bow to the pressure, power, and might of the global Roman Empire. Their advance stopped at Hadrian's Wall. Scotland had valuable natural resources like lead, silver, and gold, and the Romans knew this and wanted this, but not against massive casualties, which at the time must have been the last stronghold on planet Earth against the Roman Empire. But the Highlanders knew that the Romans got rich by charging the people they conquered taxes and forcing them to become slaves, and the tribes weren't about to give up their lands without a fight. The Romans came for the glory of Rome, and they wanted to conquer new lands and make their empire even bigger and better. But in Scotland, this empire had more than met its match. In Roman times, there was no such country as Scotland. The area of Britain, now known as Scotland, was called Caledonia, and the people were known as the Caledonians. Back then, Caledonia was made up of groups of people or tribes. Some tribes were happy to get on peacefully with the Romans, but others fought back. In the summer of AD 84, some Caledonian tribes joined forces and made a stand against the invading Roman army. The two sides fought at a place called Mons Grapios, the Grampian Mountains. The Romans were led by the Roman general Julius Agricola, and the Caledonians were led by a fierce chief called Calgacus. The Caledonians had 30,000 warriors, about twice as many as the Romans, but the Romans were better organized and defeated the Caledonians. Even though Calgacus and his army had fled, the Caledonians returned many times to raid the Roman frontier. Even though some historians think the Romans marched as far north as Caldor near Inverness, the Romans never really settled in the north. Their main concern was to protect Roman Britain from attack and the threat from surrounding nations, including defending from the Scottish allies in all directions. In the 3rd century, there was more fighting along Hadrian's Wall, only this time it was Emperor Septimius Severus, who had come to Britain to fight the invading tribes, who was defeated, and this remains the last major Roman campaign in Scotland. Although the Romans overwhelmed the Scots of antiquity, they still fell into a full-scale retreat following the death of Emperor in the year 230. Despite this, renewed attacks increased in the 4th century, and the Roman army finally packed up and left in the year of our Lord, 410. We thought you guys would appreciate the finer part of the details being discovered all the time across the world. Every era predating our modern era may have clues and aspects in their glorified systems as to who the hell us humans are and exactly what it is we are doing here. If any of you guys have any food for thought to add to the discussion, then please comment below, and as always, thank you for watching.